right now. Does anyone do a power half? Power half on top. Pretty basic turn. I think it's pretty effective. I got a lot of turns with it in high school and in college. One small adjustment I had to make in college, I'll show you guys. Another guy, big guy. Yes, thank you, sir. Appreciate it. Today. Yeah. Thank you. So, same setup. To get into my legs, I'll just do a spiral ride, pretty basic. So, spiral ride, leg goes in, same side of blocking his arm, right? Right here, hooking. So from here, I'm gonna just power half across his body. The reason I do across, if I do the same side, I'm kind of falling off to the side. So cross body. One thing I see guys do on their power halves is this, all right? This grip is not as good. I like to do kind of like this, kind of load up on my own forearm. And I'll push his head down. So right here. All right, I'll make him look at his feet, driving over his opposite shoulder, and the leg that's in is exactly like the drill we were doing. I'm gonna use it to drive. So I'm pushing off that toe in the mat. Driving over his shoulder. All right, right here. One small adjustment that's really important. As soon as I land, all right, if I don't stick my knee in his butt right here and kind of just keep it glued, he can roll all the way through, right? And I'll lose my turn. I might ride him a little bit. I might come up on top, but I lost my turn. So just to prevent it, my knee goes in his butt, right there. That leg that's free, knee goes in his butt. Now if he tries to roll into me, right, he can't, I got him stuck. If he rolls away, I just pull that shoulder to my chest, and get my back points, get your five count. If you want to pin him, so I'm gonna put my fist in the mat, and I wanna think of my arm like a telephone pole. So I want it straight up and down, right, like a telephone pole. You see some guys try to do it like this. This is okay, maybe coming on top, but I just focus on getting that straight in the ground. I just sprawl on him. See how I'm sprawling? My legs naturally come out. If I'm sprawling, there's a lot of weight on his shoulder right now. All right, and I just get him to the side, pinch it off, get the pin. All right, telephone pole like this, straight up and down. All right, if my arm's bent at all, he can wing down, and I kind of lose the half. So keep it straight and just work around it. But pretty simple power half, just a few small things. Right here, block his arm, hook in, push his head down, release your arms. Right here. Make him look at his feet. I'm gonna drive off my toe. As soon as I land that knee, that leg is free, goes right in his butt. Right here. All right, get your back points. If you wanna pin him, fist in the mat, and I just post to get my weight up. This handle post so I can get my weight on top of him. Right, I don't really worry about getting my legs out. I just kind of sprawl. Sprawl, sprawl, sprawl. And it kind of just happens naturally. All right, the more this guy fights here too, if my arm is straight, so fight down hard, the more he fights, he's gonna pin himself. All right, if he doesn't, I mean, if your arm is bent and he fights, you know, lose it. So just keep it straight. Let him fight. Sink it deep. He's gonna stick himself. Anyone have questions there? Anyone need to see it again? No? Wow. We're gonna be experts at it. Oh, you wanna see it again? I'll show it one more time. One more time, real fast. So, spiral ride, leg goes in, same side I block his arm. The reason I do that too, the side I block his arm, alright, if I'm not blocking it, if I just throw my leg in, he can catch it and get a reversal. So, that's kinda why I do that. Spiral ride, leg goes in, here. Power halfing. Make him look at his feet, drive off my toe, he goes in his butt. Right there. If you want to pin him, make your arm a telephone pole, get my weight up, and I just sprawl. And my leg comes out. Sink deep. Stick him. Plus. Alright. Alright, go to